I should receive exactly that, an image exactly as we wanted from the automation. We are going to use Home Assistant and Dudes to detect objects in camera images locally. That means no cloud services or internet connection is required for the image recognition part. It's just Home Assistant, Dudes, and your camera. Coming up! Hello, Kirill Payaskis here. Dudes stands for Dedicated Open Object Detection Service. Home Assistant stands as the best open source smart home hub out there. And camera stands... I'm kidding. Anyway, the idea to detect objects in images from the cameras added in Home Assistant and then to create automations based on the result excites me a lot. If you can relate, then stick with me till the end of this Home Assistant Dudes tutorial and you won't regret it. The Dudes software needs to be running before you can add it to Home Assistant. So let's install Dudes and start this video.
There are two options to run the Dudes software.
And because I know that you will smash that like button for the YouTube algorithm, I will show both options, so you can choose the one that suits you best.
To install a Docker client for your operating system and to run this command in your terminal. That's it, not a big deal. I will paste some links in the video description if you want to try it. The other option is to run Dudes as Home Assistant add-on, which I'm going to demonstrate to you right now. Just go to your Home Assistant supervisor add-on store and search for Dudes. If you have AMD 64-bit processor and your Home Assistant is running on that, install this add-on. If you have CUDA, this is NVIDIA technology, you can use this add-on, but because I'm going to install Dudes on Raspberry Pi 4, I'll select this one. I'll click on it and I'll just hit install. The installation is ready. I can go to configuration and there is nothing to change here. I have two detectors, default and TensorFlow, but more on that later. So I'll go back to info and I'll start the add-on. That's it, very simple. We have Dudes in Home Assistant working.
Of course, you also need at least one camera added in Home Assistant.
This is how I added several RTSP enabled cameras in my Home Assistant. You just need the RTSP link, which consists of username, password, the IP of the camera, and main or substream. I have several videos that I'll show you right now, where I'm showing how to add your Reolink, Anki, and Sonoff cameras using these methods. Basically, if your camera supports RTSP or ONVIF, you can easily add it to your Home Assistant.
Now we have everything needed to add Dudes to Home Assistant and to start detecting objects from the camera images locally. This is what you need to add in the Home Assistant configuration.
And while I'm still here in the configuration.yaml file opened with File Editor add-on, I will add the Dudes configuration right here and I will explain what it's actually doing. We will create this way an image processing service in Home Assistant. The platform will be Dudes. The scan interval will be 10,800 seconds. That means 180 minutes. The URL is the IP where Dudes is installed. In my case, it's the same machine where Home Assistant is installed. And the port, the default port is 8080. The detector is default. You can change this to TensorFlow and test if it's better for you, but I'll leave it that way. The source will be my camera entity that is added in my Home Assistant. File out is the path where the camera images will be stored. And when you call this image processing service, two files will be generated. One that's ending with latest.jpg and one with timestamp.jpg. And we have some labels here for person, car, and truck. That's it, nothing complicated. You can get this from the video description and you can adapt it for your needs. Basically, The only thing that you have to change is this IP and the camera entity. You have to change that with yours. And that's it. I'll hit save. And I'll go to configuration, server control, check config. If you don't have such menu, you have to click on your username and enable advanced options. Then I will restart my Home Assistant. When Home Assistant is restarted, I can quickly check if everything is okay by going to Developer Tools, Services, and as service I'll search for Image Processing Scan, and as entity I'll search for Dudes. Here it is actually, and I can call the service. To see the results, I can go back to States and I'll search for Dudes again. Here it is. And as you can see, the Dude service is working and I have two cars detected from my camera and Home Assistant with confidence score above 50% for both cars. But let's see a real end-to-end test.
We can make a Home Assistant and Dude's automation that will be triggered when a motion sensor is activated and if there is a car, person or truck detected in the camera image. The automation will send a still image to Telegram Messenger. Absolute beauty! I always wanted this in my home and now is the time to finally implement it. Let's go!
I'll open my file editor add-on now to edit the automations.yaml and inside I will paste two automations right here and I'll quickly explain what these automations are actually doing. You can get them from the video description, of course. So here is the quick explanation. The first one is called Motion is Detected Driveway and the trigger will be activated motion sensor. If this motion sensor becomes true, call this action Image Processing Scan and the entity will be my dude's entity that we added in the configuration.yaml file. That means try to detect any objects from the camera image. And the second automation starting from here is called Dudes Who Likes Dudes. The trigger will be change state of our Dudes entity right here. So when the image processing scan is finished, this automation will be automatically triggered. So that means the first automation triggered the second one. And we have some conditions, and these conditions are the following. If there is a car, truck, or person in the summary of the scanned image, call this action. And this action is send a message using the Telegram service with the following text, message is detected, and the following picture attached to the message. That's it. You can get this from the video description, and you can adapt it to your needs. Of course, you can change the notification part to, for example, companion app for Android, iOS, macOS, Twilio calls, and whatever you wish. I'll hit save and I'll go to configuration, server control, check config. Everything is fine and I can reload automations. I will show the Telegram window to see better, and if I move my hand in front of the sensor, I should receive exactly that, an image exactly as we wanted from the automation. When motion is detected and if there is some car, person or truck on the camera image, send a notification using Telegram saying that motion is detected and also attach a picture with the box around the detected objects. Perfect! That is exactly what I wanted. Great! It is working!
Many thanks to my digital friend Alex who bring Dudes to my attention. You can meet us both in my Discord server where we talk a lot about smart home stuff. You can find the invite link in the video description. Make sure that you hit the subscribe, like and bell buttons if you enjoyed this video. Stay safe and don't forget, home smart, but not hard. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in my next video.